trying to create a conversation between a lot of us that motivated one another. Like, I'm not sure, Kurt, you know how inspiring you were to us. We didn't communicate a lot when we were younger, but I followed everything that you did, and it allowed me to go into high school, to strive to be great. Just from everything, just from how the gear matched, how you conducted yourself, to even how going to the Kessler and Tim Stewart and Dave Elias right there, and not backing down from that. That inspired me to, when I played against Weaver McDuffie, played against Rob, it gave me that confidence to kind of push. So I'll start with Rob. What was your first recollection of watching Kurt play, and how influential was he to you in your game?
I would say the first recollection was the first time I saw Kurt was on TV on Super 7. Now, Super 7 used to count down. He was number one on Super 7 as a sophomore. At the time, I was maybe 7th or 8th grade. And the thing that struck me at the time, because I had seen Kurt at the club but didn't know who he was. But then I saw him on the Super 7. And, you know, they show the highlights, and then after the highlights, they do the interview. And I was impressed because, you know, back at that time, without the social media, without the highlights and all the stuff we have access today, it was cool for us to get in the paper. We just wanted to see the box score, not even the article. To be on TV was something altogether different. To actually be on TV, and then to see a young cat in 10th grade at the time, speaking on TV. And so when I saw this interview, I was like, that's the dude from the club. And so the next time I came to the club, my eyes was trained on this dude. And I watched, really, and we've talked about this, I watched everything he did because I was serious. I was really serious. Like a lot of us, I really wanted to be good. It meant something to me. So as a young person, to see somebody that was really serious and was right there in front of me, and I had the opportunity to watch him every day, I really was one of the people that took full advantage of that. I was, you used the word inspired. I was inspired by what I saw because I felt like I was watching a professional on television just the way he was speaking as a 10th grader.
So during this time, Kurt, were you aware that so many eyes was on you from that perspective?
It's interesting you say that. I was aware, only simply because Joe made me aware. He would often say, Kurt, listen, man, they're watching me. And, you know, again, I didn't know it was Rob. I didn't know it was you, but I knew the younger generation that was coming up was watching me. So, in many respects, every time I walked in the gym, it was like a game for me. We wasn't just running up and down. Because every time I took a shot, I knew you guys were watching. My follow through, you know, from my feet to my release. So I wanted to be perfect because I wanted to inspire you. Work ethic. We talked about Calvin Murphy. You know Calvin Murphy? That's a young buck. Calvin Murphy's 5'9", weighed about 150 pounds, and led the NBA in scoring, assists the same year. So I wanted to be like Calvin Murphy simply because I didn't think I was going to grow. And when Big Vitale was speaking, he was spitting, he was sweating, and he was really working out while he was speaking. That's how passionate he was about working out.